thusang batho jaanong re o amogetse le rona ntse re thusega ga ntse re itswaletse jalo. E botlhokwa thata gore re dire lockdown because re utlwile gore gate bolwetse bo bo tsamaya ga batho ba ntse ba kopana jalo. That's right. Amen. Thank you so much for the privilege to be invited on your platform, as Shekinah Tabernacle, as you have said. My name is Raymond, and one of the associates and evangelists there in Shekinah Tabernacle. I'm quickly and briefly going to get straight into the word of the Lord in the book of Luke, chapter number 12, and then we'll read from verse number 3 to 5. We'll read from verse number 3 to 5. Luke chapter number 12, verse number 3 to 5. Luke ake kaulo, and then timana ki abo raru kufita kaya abo tano. Luke chapter number 12, bareti jalo bato lepele jalo hoka kiriya. Di bibile tabo na ba bale timana iu eretari samfa moleta tina kajigo. Hallelujah. We are looking forward for God to intervene. We are looking forward to manifest victory upon our lives. I'm reading that book, Luke chapter number 12, verse number 3. To 5. I tell you, my friends, do not fear those who kill the body, and that after have nothing more that they can do, but I will warn you whom to fear. Fear him who, after he has killed, has authority to cast into hell. Yes, I tell you, fear him. Can I read that scripture again? I tell you, my friends, do not fear those who kill the body, and after that have nothing more that they can do. But I will warn you whom to fear. Fear him who, after he has killed, has authority to cast into hell. Yes, I tell you, fear him. Father, I bless you for the reading of your word. Your word is alive. Your word is active. It's sharper than any double edged sword. I pray that, Lord, the listeners of this program at Mafisa, my God, they are going to receive the word and their lives are going to be transformed. In Jesus' name I have prayed. Beloved, the scripture that we have read here, Jesus, he's speaking to his disciples. As he was speaking to his disciples, he calls them. He says, my friends, it was in the midst of the multitude. And the Bible says he found an opportunity to speak to his disciples. And as he was speaking to his disciples, he's going to repeat this word. Do not fear those who kill. Do not fear. And he come again. He says, fear. And he says, fear him. And he says, fear again. Four times in these two verses, we see Jesus Christ saying to his disciples that there is something that you don't have to fear. There is someone that you don't have to fear, but there is also somebody that you have to fear. Now, I'm reminded at one stage here that David at Ziklag was under fire in the book of 1 Samuel chapter number 30 from verse 1 until the last verse. Ziklag was under fire. And the enemy took the wives and the children of David and his men, the Amalekites. They took the wives and the children of the men of Ziklag. They went away with them. The Bible tells us that when David and the men arrived, they found the city in smoke. They found the city burning. But I came here today to challenge you and to encourage you, to say to you, you need to realize that there is an assurance of victory, even in time of devastation, even in time of distresses, even when times are very difficult. But there is an assurance that I want to leave with you, that there shall be a victory over and over evil. There shall be victory over evil. As I want to encourage you a little bit, I want to title this, the caption of this word, limited bruises. Limited bruises, limited bruises. It's important to realize that whatever that you are going through here on earth is limited. It's limited. Now, David, when he arrived at Ziklag and he found the city burning, the Bible says he was under so much distress, but he encouraged himself in the Lord. There is a place that you need to get to encourage yourself. Courage comes from the Lord. Courage is found in the place of God. Courage is found in the place called the Lord. Now, if you want courage in times that you are going through, you need to be like David when he was experiencing devastation, when things were difficult, when he was going through pain, the families being divided from men, the wives and children being taken away from men. The Bible says David went before the Lord and he encouraged himself. But verse number 8 of that chapter, 1 Samuel chapter number 8, chapter number 30, verse number 8, the Bible says, then David inquired of the Lord, shall I pursue after this, and shall I overtake them? He answered him, pursue, for you shall overtake. Pursue, for you shall overtake, and you shall surely rescue. Now, David, before he could follow after the enemy, before he can pursue the enemy, he wanted an assurance of victory. The scripture, therefore, beloved, encourages me and you that we should always never go to war unless we are able or we have checked our ability to come back with victory. We should never attempt to fight without knowing that we shall come back with victory. That is why Jesus was giving this parable as he was speaking to the disciples. He was encouraging them that when they decide to follow him, when they decide to become his disciples, they need to realize that they need to carry their cross, they need to follow them. But in spite of their cross, there shall be victory. Said to them, or what a king going out to encounter another king in war will not sit down first and deliberate whether he is able with 10,000 to beat him, or he comes against him with 20,000. Now here that Jesus was saying, before you go to war, look at what the kings are doing. He was encouraging the people that the kings, before they go to war, they check their ability if they are going to come back with victory. But I came here to challenge you in the times that you are experiencing now, in the pandemic that you are facing now, in this enemy that is in confronting the people of God. I came to tell you that is one of the limited bruises of the enemy. Those are limited bruises of the enemy. I can assure you today, wonderful listener of this beautiful radio station, that there is an assurance of victory. If you can realize that there is a place in the Lord, you encourage yourself in the Lord. There is an assurance of victory. The enemy know, or the enemy we are in battle with, he is aware, or we are aware if you are in the Lord, that he is limited. He is limited to the heel. He is limited to the flesh. He is limited to the body. Do not fear the one who is able to kill the body. And after killing the body, he does not know what has nothing to do more. But there is the one that you need to fear. The one who has authority to take the soul of the body to hell. The one who has authority to deal with the soul of the head or of the body and take it to hell. Now, Satan, the enemy, is limited to the heel. Satan, the enemy, is limited to the flesh. Satan, the enemy, is limited to the body. So his bruises are always limited. His bruises are always limited. I don't know what you're experiencing now. I don't know what you're going through now. But I came to challenge you, a wonderful listener, that the enemy's bruises are always limited. You are not supposed to fear the limited enemy, but there is one that you can always fear, is God Almighty. He has authority over all life, even over the enemy himself. Now, I want to challenge you to understand that this pandemic, I look at it and I see it as a limited bruise of the enemy. This is what God said to the serpent in Genesis chapter number 3, verse number 14 and 15. This is what God said to the enemy. Said the Lord God said to the serpent, because you have done this, cursed are you above all livestock, above all beasts of the field, and your belly, on your belly you shall go, and the dust you shall eat all the days of your life. He said, I will put an enmity between you and the woman, between your offspring and her offspring. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel. Now, Satan's bruises are always limited to the heel, are limited to the flesh. But the offspring of the woman, who is now everyone from Cain until you and me, we become the offspring of the woman. But the ideal offspring of the woman is Jesus Christ himself. We are all the offsprings of Eve, but Jesus is the ideal offspring of the woman. Jesus is the one who is an ideal. Now, Satan's power was limited to the he, but also when you look at Job chapter number 2, verse number 6, you will realize that the Bible says God allowed Satan to touch Job, and when Satan was touching, he said, you just leave his soul. You can touch his flesh. You can bring sores upon his body, but the soul you cannot touch. I have authority over the soul. So I came to tell you today that the bruises of Satan, they are limited. He is bruising your children. He is bruising your marriage. He is bruising your relationships. He is bruising your husband, your wife. He is bruising your spouse. I came to tell you today that the bruises of Satan are limited. It is limited bruises. They are just limited bruises. I challenge you today that God rebukes the devil. God rebukes the devil. In Zechariah chapter number 3, verse 1 and 2, he was standing accusing Joshua, the high priest. He was standing before Joshua, the high priest, accusing him. And the Bible says in verse number 2, and the Lord said to Satan, the Lord rebuke you, O Satan. The Lord who has chosen Jerusalem rebuke you. Is not this the brand plucked out from fire? I came to challenge you that God is still rebuking the devil today. His bruises are limited. Limited bruises of Satan is something that you're not supposed to fear. All you need to realize that there is a place to go to. There is a place to go to and encourage yourself in the Lord. There is a place to go to and encourage yourself in the Lord. That place is the place where the Lord God Almighty is. When we come by the throne of his grace, we know that the devil does not have access to the throne. Even when he tries to accuse us, he's not going to overcome. But what we are looking forward for is the victory that we are assured of. We know that his bruises are just limited. His bruises are just limited. Now, we are the offspring of Eve. We are the Zerah of Eve, the offspring of Eve. And here I came to challenge you that you can look up for the victory that comes from the Lord. I have just told you that when Satan here was busy with his work, John chapter number 1, 1 John chapter number 3 rather, verse number 8, it says that Satan has been sinning from the beginning, doing evil things and attacking, but Jesus came to destroy the works of the evil one. Jesus came to destroy the works of the evil one. Therefore, you can take courage and realize that the bruises of Satan are just limited. The bruises of Satan are just limited. Jesus overcame him, conquered him at the cross of Calvary. The ideal offspring of Eve conquered Satan, conquered the limited bruises of Satan at the cross of Calvary. And we as the church, we as those who believe in God, we shall ultimately see a victory. In Romans chapter number 16, verse number 20, the Bible says, the God of peace will soon crush Satan under your feet. My Lord, my God, the God of peace will soon crush Satan under your feet, and the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Now, the Bible says the victory that which Jesus accomplished for the church, accomplished for the people of God, is going to be manifested in the body of Christ, in the church. Paul was writing to the Romans church, and he said to them that the God of peace will soon crush Satan who is under your feet. I came to tell you today that coronavirus is like the limited bruiser, is always under the feet. Unless you come to its level, then it will bruise your hurt. But when you always know that it is under my feet, you are going to come out with an assured victory. I came to challenge you today that the limited bruises should not fear you. The limited bruises should not fear you, but you should always look unto the one who has authority even over the soul. I came to challenge you today that those bruises of the pandemic, they are just limited. Those bruises, they are just limited to the flesh. They are limited to the healer. They
are limited to the body. But when we come, the same thing that Jesus did, the same thing that David did to Goliath, we do a fatality, an attack on the head. Now, the poison of the snake is in the head. When you crush the head of the snake, you are destroying the poison of the snake. What will be left then? It is a bodiless, a poisonless body of the serpent. And I came to challenge you today that you know that the bruises of Satan are limited. That all Satan that is having now is a poisonless body. We can look at it and say, we know the one who has authority. You do not have authority. Now you don't have to be under fear. Jesus, the Bible says, he came and become like us to die so that we should not be enslaved. That's Hebrews chapter number 2, verse number 15 and 14 and 15. That we should not be under this and be enslaved by the one who has the power of death. Jesus conquered for us. So the enemy and the one who has the power of death does not have any say upon our lives. His bruises are limited. Those are just the limited bruises that I came to challenge you. As an offspring of Eve, you need to know that there is victory certain for you. There is victory that is assured for you. There is victory that is certain for you. You soon, God says, sooner I will crush the enemy under your feet. Sooner I will crush the enemy under your feet. Sooner I will crush the enemy under your feet. I came to challenge you. I tell you, my friends, do not fear those who kill the body. After that, they have nothing more that they can do. But I will warn you to fear him who, after he has killed, has authority to cast into hell. Yes, I tell you, you fear him. I came here to tell you that Satan has been limited. The bruises are limited. This, what we are seeing in our times, it's limited bruises of the devil. It's limited bruises of Satan. This that we are seeing in our time is just limited bruises of Satan. I challenge you to realize that there is victory found in Christ. Victory found in the ideal son, ideal offspring of Eve. And the Bible says when he sent out the 72 in Luke chapter number 10, verse 17 through to 19, he said he sent the 72 out. And one day they came back, they brought the report. They said, Lord, even the demons are subject to us in your name. Even the demons are subject to us in your name. This pandemic, it's part of the demonic attacks of the enemy. It is just limited bruises of Satan. They have no power. And God, Jesus said to them, he said to them, I saw Satan fall like a lightning from heaven. Every time you lift up that name of Jesus Christ, the name of Jesus Christ, Jesus sees Satan falling down. Every time you call on the name of God, Jesus is what watching Satan falling down. The order as you do it, Satan keeps on falling. Satan keeps on falling because his place is a bottomless pit. His diseases are supposed to be with him in the bottomless pit. Every time you call on the name of Jesus, Satan is falling down. These are just limited bruises that I came to challenge you, that do not fear everything that has power to take the body but cannot do anything with the soul. What do you need to do? You need to make sure that your soul is on the hands of the one who has authority, that your soul is in the hands of Jesus Christ. And if your soul is in the hands of Jesus, your life is secured, your life is assured, your life is safe, your life is protected, your life is preserved. Everything that is happening, that is a pain, that causing hurtings in your life, in your marriage, in your family, in your work, in your finances, in everything that you're going through, they are just limited bruises of the enemy. But I can tell you of the victory that you will find in the Son of God. He says, so soon I will crush the enemy who is under your feet. Soon, God says, soon I will do it. This we are seeing is just the limited bruises of the enemy. I therefore challenge you to surrender your life unto him who has authority on the soul and on the body. Satan's bruises are limited to the him, are limited to the flesh, but you are limited to the body, but you know that your soul is in the right hands, the hands of Jesus. That's the encouragement that I want to leave with you. If you have believed that word and you want to receive it, follow me with this prayer and make it your prayer so your life can be saved. so your life can be protected. But tell about how we talk about na modi atin sa mudi. Kuruske wa na le poi for we to mudi mo ona offense what to them power matter ali so. Abilo uhun sa mo kubo mo kobe ba poi for le so. Moletati naka jim. I would like to pray with you, and the good Lord will do you well. Just follow me with this prayer. Say, Lord Jesus. Kya hulebo. Moletati naka jim. But tell about. Umodi atin sa ha. Ke a go amogela jwale ka morena le mopholosi wa botshelo baka. Ke a leboga gore ke pholositswe ke ngwana wa Modimo. Amen and amen. If you have prayed that prayer, you have received him as your Lord and Savior. And I can say to you, your life will never be the same again. That's an assurance that you are going to see victory. These are just limited bruises. Thank you very much, me Moditswe. Thank you, me. Amen, amen, amen. It's our pleasure, man. Thank you so much. Thank you. We are going to advise you to please just like, share, and subscribe to all our channels, and the good Lord will do you well. God bless you. You have been connecting with us live on Facebook. We appreciate you. May the good Lord bless you. Stay blessed. Shalom, shalom, shalom.